Breaking Caylee Anthony news, Judge Belvin Perry has ordered that Caylee must pay nearly $100,000 to local investigators. Good afternoon. I'm Jim Payne.
I'm Martha Sigalski. The amount is far less than what the sheriff and state attorney's office had asked for, but it's still a hefty price for a woman who hasn't had a job in years.
Now, WESH 2's Amanda Ober joins us now with the breaking details. Amanda?
This really is sort of a mixed victory for both sides. Clearly, it will be a hardship for Caylee to pay back $100,000. She's indigent, but Caylee is also not having to pay the $500,000 the state wanted to get out of her.
The state attorney's office wanted Caylee Anthony to pay a total of $517,000. That represents all of the costs related to Caylee's criminal case and prosecution. The state said it had a right to demand that money because Caylee repeatedly lied to investigators and knew that her daughter Caylee was never really missing. In his ruling Thursday, Judge Belvin Perry did rule Caylee must pay out some significant cash. But he sided with Caylee's defense team, saying the amount Caylee has to pay should only cover the period when detectives were investigating a missing person and not the homicide case. The sum he ordered Caylee to pay falls just short of $100,000. Here's the breakdown. $61,500 to FDLE, $10,300 to the Metropolitan Bureau of Investigation, $25,800 to the Sheriff's Office, and a mere $50 to the State Attorney's Office. In a statement released this afternoon, the state attorney said, "We are pleased that some taxpayer money will be returned to the agencies. We respect the court's decision and thorough research of the case law."
Caylee Anthony is serving probation at an undisclosed location in Florida for unrelated check fraud charges. Her attorneys have said she's taking classes and getting some help, but that she is indigent and has no source of income. So just how Caylee will meet this financial obligation is unclear. Her attorneys have not responded to her calls yet. Amanda Ober reporting WESH 2 News.